already done in discussing the sum, difference, product, and quotient of function. So now let's move on to the composite function. So when we say composite function, it is created when one function is substituted into another function. So gaya ng nakikita nyo dito sa ating example, so we have a given of f of x is equal to 3x plus 2 and g of x is equal to x plus 5. So sabi natin sa ating definition, one function is substituted into another function. So we have here the f of g of x is equal to f of x plus 5. So yung g of x natin, the value of the g of x is x plus 5. So sa substitute natin kay x ni f function. So ito na yun, f of x plus 5. And then the value of the x in our f, itong function na ito, yung 3x plus 2, the x here is we need to substitute the x plus 5. So 3 times x plus 5 plus 2. So distributive property, 3x. 3 times x is 3x. And then 3 times 5 is 15 plus 2. And then 3x, 15 plus 2 is 17. So how about the g composed of f of x? So ito siya. We have g of f of x is equal to, so yung value ng ating g of x, yung x na value niya doon is yung ating f of x. So ano ba yung f of x natin? Yun yung 3x plus 2. Therefore, kapag i-rewrite natin ito, we have g of 3x plus 2. And then after getting the value of the x of the g, substitute natin itong x na to sa ating g of x, which is the x plus 5. So yung x doon, substitute natin si 3x plus 2. So 3x plus 2 plus 5. And then 3x, 2 plus 5 is 7. So ganun yung composite function. And then we have another example here. We have the given of q of x is equal to 4x minus 3. R of x is equal to x minus 5. S of x is equal to x squared minus 10x plus 25. So we need to find q composed of R of x and then the s composed of q of x. Isosolve muna natin si q composed of R of x. Kapag sinulat natin ito sa ating, or kapag in-expand natin, magiging ganyan, q of R of x. So itong q natin, ito yon, and then yung value ng x na ito is the R of x. Ano ba yung R of x natin? X minus 5. So, magiging q of x minus 5. And then, kapag na-substitute na natin itong r of x natin na x minus 5, yung value ng ating q of x, ito, yung q of x natin, yung value ng ating x is x minus 5. So, we need to substitute the x minus 5 sa ating x. So, magiging 4 times x minus 5. So, sinubstitute natin si x minus 5 dito. So, ito na siya. 4 times x is equal to 4x. And then 4 times negative 5 is negative 20 minus 3. And then combine like terms. So since mag-isa lang si linear term, copy lang natin. And then the final answer is 4x minus 23. So negative 20 minus 3 is negative 23. The final answer of q composed of r of x is equal to 4x minus 23. So how about the other one? We have to find the s composed of q of x. So kapag in-expand natin, magiging s of q of x. So once again, itong s natin, ito, yung value ng x is Q of x. So, ano ba yung Q of x natin? 4x minus 3. So, ayan. S of 4x minus 3. So, yung value ng x natin dito sa S is 4x minus 3. So, we need to substitute 4x minus 3 in every variable sa ating S of x. So, magiging ganito. X, substitute natin si 4x minus 3. Magiging 4x minus 3 squared minus 10x, substitute natin ito, magiging negative 10 times 4x minus 3 plus 25. So we need to simplify the 4x minus 3 squared and then the negative 10 times 4x minus 3. So 4x squared magiging 16x squared. And then we need 2 twice the product of the first and second term. So pag multiply natin ito at i-times 2 natin. So 4x times negative 3 is negative 12x times 2 is negative 24x. Plus negative 3 squared is 9. So how about this one? So negative 10 times 4x is negative 40x. And then negative 10 times negative 3 is positive 30 plus 25. And then ang next na gagawin is combine like terms. So magiging 16x squared. Copy lang natin to since wala siyang kaparehas. And then negative 24x. Tabi lang natin si negative 40x since they are like terms. And then positive 9 plus 30 plus 25. Therefore, the answer is S of Q of x is equal to 16x squared. Negative 24x minus 40x is negative 64x. 9 plus 30 is 39 plus 25 is 64. Therefore, the final answer is ito. So, ganun lang kadali ang pag-solve ng composite function. So, that's it for today. Thank you for listening.